Tiffany here with Years of Years and
Brad again.
Brad's back for another episode of This Day in Disney, and we are talking about August 12th. And so to start off, we're heading to 1965, and on this day, Mary Adams entered the Disneyland park, and she was the 50 millionth guest to the park.
In 1965.
Yes, in 1965. I thought this was really cool because it was actually the 10th anniversary year, not on the day, but Disneyland had been open for 10 years and they had already received their 50 millionth guest. That just seems astronomical for the time period, right?
Yeah, I think the power of television too.
Yeah.
The World of Color and the Disney World show. I mean, yeah. Disneyland show.
Walt did really good at promoting his theme park. Wouldn't we all love to have our own show to
promote all of our projects? I think more than ever, a lot of people do.
Yeah, that's true, actually. So that was basically it. There's lots of different milestones like that with Disneyland and all the parks. And as I brought up with Tokyo, and their big milestone, I think it was last week, but I think it's interesting, these people, and I couldn't find any information online if they, like, I don't know,
gave something,
gave balloons, yeah, or said hooray. I'm sure they did something. So if you guys know, like, what the celebratory thing is when you're like the, what would it be, 1 billionth guest? I don't know, Animal Kingdom.
It's like the McDonald's thing. Went, yeah, from millions to billions.
Yeah, so very interesting history.
Hello, here. Billionth guest at Disney.
Yeah, we don't know. Mm-hmm. All right, we'll talk about it another day. But anyway, next up on this day in 2016, Pete's Dragon is released to the American public. So that's why I had Brad
along.
That's
really why I'm here, yeah.
Yes.
I was so excited about that film. I mean, I even posted that, like, on my personal Facebook and Instagram back in the day, like my ticket up at the theater. It was, we were just really looking forward to it.
Right. Yeah. So just so you know, this was the remake of the 1977 live action animated musical film of the exact same name. And this remake, this particular remake, tells the story of an orphaned feral boy who befriends a dragon in the Pacific Northwest, which causes repercussions in the nearing town, and but it's their discovery by the local residents. So this film was released in 2D and Disney Digital 3D and then Real 3D. The film did receive positive reviews, and it did star Bryce Howard, and you had Robert Redford in it as well. So,
yeah. Honestly,
well, to start off, the reason you were so excited, we were all so excited, because
we were talking about Condor Man last week, and I talked about my top three, and believe it or not, the original Pete's Dragon is one of those. I'll just tell you the other one, Bed Knobs and Broomsticks, too.
We'll get
and
there.
Black Hole. I'm like,
Black.
The Black Hole. No, the Black Hole.
Black Hole, that one.
I just,
I
love those.
Not a lot of people like that one, so we'll really have to delve in that
with
you.
I love those early VHS, but Pete's Dragon, one of my favorite Disney songs.
Yes.
Like, it's, I mean, I'm tempted to say my favorite. The original. Yeah, I mean, we're going to go back to the original.
Yes, and delve into it more deeply, but tell us what the favorite song is.
Oh, the one, It's Not Easy to find someone who cares. It's not easy to find magic in pairs.
You really like the music.
I do.
From the original.
Really.
And the second,
the music.
The remake was not a musical at all.
It wasn't.
Right.
But I'll tell you this much.
It's a live action.
When I saw the trailer, because, like, I hold the first one, like, so dear, I was a little bit concerned that it was going to be, like, too dramatic.
Mm-hmm.
And, I mean, it was dramatic, and the, you know, realization of the fur and everything on Pete, the emotion, everything. I really, really, really enjoyed it, but it's totally a reboot.
It's totally different.
Totally a reboot.
I think I honestly just didn't like it
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, I can't go that far.
I know. I think you did, and I'm pretty sure our kids did.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I really love the classic a lot. So this was one that I had a hard time on the remake.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think maybe because the kids and I really like the Jurassic Park movies with Bryce Howard.
Mm.
And I don't know, maybe it just...
Yeah.
Intertwined too much for me. I'm not sure. I don't know why.
What was her first movie too with the pool?
The M. Night Shyamalan
film. Yeah,
right, that was Lady in the Water.
Lady in the Water.
I don't know if
she's
that was
amazing.
Was that her first film?
I believe it was.
I mean, it was the first one we saw her in and loved her in.
I believe it was our first. Yeah.
Yeah, that's our level of. Not to give anything away, that's our level of scary.
Yeah, for real. Yeah. We watched a horror movie 2 years ago.
Did
the
we?
Visit.
That
the
was
3 years
Night
ago.
Shyamalan, too.
Was it really?
Yeah.
I don't know.
We
don't do
so
it.
So I don't think we can do a Night Shyamalan even. We're just, our tolerance is very low. Our pain tolerance is probably higher than our viewing scary film tolerance.
For sure. We don't even do like horror nights in Universal and stuff like that.
No, we haven't. I mean...
We don't.
We might. I wouldn't ever say we're never going to do that.
Yeah.
We're just pretty Disney faithful. For the most part, don't
Indeed.
Have those.
It happens that way. For
yeah,
us,
Universal
for sure.
passes or anything like that. So we just haven't gotten over there. But back to Pete's Dragon, it was. I think it was well produced. Obviously, lots of people really liked it. So don't take my word for it. If you haven't seen it, you should definitely check it out. Or suggest you checking out the original too.
Mm-hmm.
I think maybe for me, it's this is what set me off right away is just the car accident. There's a car accident right at the beginning, and this little toddler, I mean, the little boy loses his parents. Like, he's orphaned right in the movie.
Yeah, it's deeply emotional and dramatic.
Yeah, everything.
But it works. I mean, it's good. It's great.
So,
I have watched
it's intense.
Like 3 or 4 times.
Yeah.
So... That's saying something because I don't really rewatch movies a lot.
Right.
Like there's a couple that I do and that's one of them.
Yeah. Yeah. I definitely rewatch it too. It's the classic 1977.
Oh no, I'm talking about the new one too. I've watched it 3 times.
Oh, you've watched it 3 times?
The classic I've watched like, I don't even know.
Yeah.
60.
Wow, you've watched it 3 times?
Yeah.
He never watches modern
really
movies
don't.
That often.
I really don't.
So that's
once,
surprising.
Twice. So I do love it actually.
Yeah.
I have to admit, I love the new Pete's Dragon.
Good. I'm glad
yeah.
you like it. I think if that beginning scene was different, I'd probably like it even
it
more.
It is shocking.
Maybe I need to watch it again at least one more time so that I know that that's already going to happen. So I'm desensitized, I guess. Anyway. But that's it for this day in Disney. And it's so fun having you here.
Thank you for having me.
And hopefully we'll see Brad again sometime soon. And hopefully we'll see you guys soon. And I hope you have a great day. We'll see you next time. Bye.
Bye.